Hey, to watch soaps.
So, how do I look?
Smashingly businesslike.
I was asking Allie.
Well, she thinks that you look just perfect.
Well, Allie doesn't have much to compare me now, do you? And Allie also thinks that her mother is like nothing else in the world.
Right now, our mother's just one of millions of women who is trying to handle career and home life at the same time.
And you're doing a terrific job at both.
You've got to get to work, and so do I.
What are you working on?
Well, I've got to finish this piece on possible first ladies, as long as Allie lets me, anyway.
Allie, now you're going to let your mom finish her work today, aren't you, honey? Yeah.
It was a lot easier at the office.
Well, it'll get easier here once you work out a system.
I really shouldn't complain. I know a lot of people have it worse than I do. Now, you run along now to that big outside world. Allie and I will hold down the fort here.
Great. I'll see you.
Let me know if I have any more assignments.
Yeah, I'll call. I love you.
Evan, what's wrong? Is something wrong at the office?
Hold your horses, I'm coming.
Hi there.
Hi, did anybody ever teach you to knock quietly?
Well, I did knock quietly, but nobody answered.
Well, what can I do for you?
I understand that Jamie Frame lives here.
That's right, for the time being.
Can I see him?
Not until you tell me who you are.
My name is Jake McKinnon.
Oh, your dad runs that coffee house.
My Uncle Vince runs that coffee house. And who are you?
I'm Charlene Watts. I'm Jamie's aunt.
So that makes you Jason's sister.
That's correct. Speak of Satan. I'll get Jamie's out in the yard.
Hey, Jake, how are things?
Okay.
Just okay. Is that because you're here in the enemy camp?
Is that what this is now, Jason? The enemy camp?
Well, that depends on why you want to see Jamie, doesn't it?
I'd say that's a personal matter.
But your sister-in-law, the one he had the little affair with.
Hello, Jake.
What's up? That's what I came to find out, Jamie.
The fanciest dive that ever was dove was done by Melissa of Coconut Grove. She bounced on the board and flew into the air with a twist of her head and a twirl of her hair. She did 34 jackknives. Oh, my goodness, 34. That's a really strong girl, huh? Let's see what else she does here. 34 jackknives, backflipped and spun, quadruple gainered and reached for the sun and then somersaulted 9 times in a quarter and looked down and saw that the pool had no water. Oh, no. What? Marley!
I'll come back when you're
finished. Oh, no. Here. Play with your blocks a second. Marley, no. Honey, we need to talk.
Is there a problem?
You know there is. We do. We need to talk. Michael told me.
What did he tell
me? I am so upset.
Donna, what did Michael tell you?
Wait. Just a minute. Mikey, come on. Let's take some of these and go in the kitchen and play with Bridget, okay? Can you pick all this up? Here, take one more. Okay, come on. We'll go this way. Here we go. She's right in the kitchen. Go run in there. See if she has any cookies for you, too, okay?
He is so adorable.
Yes, he is. He's very, very smart, too. You wouldn't believe.
Oh, sometimes I envy Victoria so much because she has a child coming.
Well, Victoria really isn't in any position to be envied.
I know. But no matter what circumstance she may be in, I suppose I still envy her.
Honey, Michael told me that you're not able to have children. I'm so sorry.
Are you really?
Yes, yes, of course I am. I just wish that you felt like you could have trusted me enough to have confided in me.
Well, Donna, I cannot confide in you if you are always attacking Jake.
I know. I will try not to do that anymore.
Just because I cannot have his child?
No, of course not.
Well, good. Good, because I am not going to give up until I can.
Morning, Amanda.
It's early morning.
I know. I just wanted to talk to you before I started my day at the office. May I come in?
Sure. As long as you're quiet. I just put Ellie down to sleep.
Okay. Oh, what a quaint little place you have here. These old lofts make great apartments.
Thanks. You like it?
You know, Rachel was telling me that you'll be spending most of your time doing your work from home.
Yeah. So you just came by to make sure that my typewriter is working properly, or...?
No, you just haven't turned in your expense vouchers.
I haven't even filled them out yet.
Well, you should stay on top of things like that so we can reimburse you on time.
Right. Well, I'm glad you reminded me. I do tend to let things like that slide.
Here. If you sign them, we'll have you checked by this afternoon.
It can wait till I come into the office.
No, Liz was telling me that sometimes you're, short for cash.
Right to tell you that.
No, she was just explaining to me why you brought the baby into the office yesterday.
I brought the baby into the office yesterday because my babysitter was sick.
You don't have to be defensive.
I'm not being defensive.
Well, good. There's no need to be. Everybody gets strapped for cash from time to time.
Evan, I've got to get back to work, you know, if I'm going to beat this deadline.
Okay, look, I won't stay much longer. Look, if there's anything I can do for you while your folks are going through this crisis with the Marston trial, will you let me know, please?
Yeah, thank you.
It's just too bad they've got to deal with, and contend with such unpleasantness.
Well, we'll get through it. Daddy will be cleared, I'm sure of it.
This is very intriguing. It's an original. You know, Sam really is as talented as your mother told me.
What makes you so sure that's his?
Well, painters don't usually leave other artists' work lying about.
Well, he's not very happy with that one.
Oh, you see, that's what they call creative discontent, isn't it? I mean, it's just, he must really resent doing graphics when he's so good at this.
He's very good at his job, too.
Oh, indeed he is, but he's much better at this. I mean, it's too bad he can't spend all his time doing it.
Evan, I really gotta get back to work before Allie wakes up.
Oh, right. Shh, sorry. Listen, it was nice talking to you, and I'll see you in the office soon. Bye.
Well, Jake, I'm not sure I understand exactly what you mean.
Can we talk him on, Jamie?
Sure. Why not?
Those new specs.
Jason?
Yeah?
Do me a favor and work on that someplace else so Jake and I can have a nice little chat.
Jamie, I got some really important calls.
Oh, don't worry. Listen, if they come, I'll just give you a yell.
Okay. Field is all yours.
Okay, Jake, what is it?
You know damn well why I'm here,
Jake. Well, let me take a wild guess, then. Vicky?
She's been one of my closest friends since we were kids.
I know.
I feel like I'm her brother.
Please, go on.
Let's just say that I'm here talking to you as if I were.
Oh, okay. I think I get the idea, Jake.
I want you to do the right thing by her, Jake.
Jake, I'm hoping to do the right thing for everybody concerned, especially the baby.
She loves you, man.
Just let me finish now. I have a decision to make here real soon. And no one is going to force me to that decision by putting pressure on me.
I'm not trying to put pressure on you.
Good. Because I don't react very well to it.
So, Vicky tells me that you and Lisa came up with the idea of bringing up the baby.
It was one of several possible solutions.
Not a very good one.
Yeah, well, we came to the same conclusion ourselves, Jake.
Was marrying Vicky a possible solution?
I'm engaged to Lisa.
Well, Lisa's not pregnant, or at least I assume she's not pregnant.
Jake, I suggest you back off.
I just don't want to see Vicky get hurt.
Well, neither do I, bud.
You should have thought about that when you slept with her.
You think I wanted to get her pregnant?
Who cares what you want, Jamie? That's what happened.
Yeah, well, I'm beginning to think that Vicky had this plan from the very start.
Well, that's just a cheap shot from somebody who survived with two lousy marriages.
Well, don't start calling names.
You started it with what you said about Vicky, man.
You know, Jake, you're beginning to really make me mad.
So what? Why don't you just step out? You want to come outside, Jamie?
God, that's
hey,
how...
Guys, why don't you knock it off? They can hear you all the way to Hudson Farm.
You're not going to duck this, Jamie.
Uh-huh.
Vicky may let it go, but I'm not going to. Help him out.
Do I have to ask what that's all about?
Hey, Amanda.
Hi, Vicky.
Who are you talking to?
Myself.
Well, it sounds like you have a lot to say to you.
No, just a deadline to meet, that's all.
Oh, I'm interrupting.
No, that's okay. Ellie's been doing it all morning. Come on in.
Oh, Amanda, it must be tough working at home.
Well, it has its advantages.
Well, would it help if I took Ellie off your hands for a couple of hours?
You would do that?
Oh, I would love to. I'll take her to the park and get some exercise.
You sure?
Yes, I would love it. I need to get used to having a little baby around, you know?
That'd be great.
Good. You know what? Before you leave, why don't you sit down? We'll talk for a little while. Terrific. Do you want something to drink?
Oh, tea? No, thanks.
Breakfast? No, thanks. How have you been feeling?
A little nauseous in the morning.
Oh, I can remember that.
And my clothes aren't fitting anymore.
Get used to it.
I will. No, I'm getting used to that part.
Hmm. You know, the most important thing is attitude. You've got to keep yourself optimistic.
Oh, I know, but it's a little difficult in my situation.
You just tell yourself that you can handle anything. You can raise that baby on your own if you have to.
I know. Is that what you used to tell yourself before you married Sam?
Among other things.
But you knew he was going to come through for you, right?
Oh, I had my doubts at times.
Yeah, just like me.
Well, it wasn't exactly the same.
Well, I know. I mean, besides the fact that Sam wasn't engaged to another woman, it was a little similar.
Well, we had our own set of problems.
But they all worked out.
Yeah, with a little help from our friends.
And now everything's happy, right?
I guess... actually happier. I'm happier than I've ever dreamed.
Well, I doubt it's gonna work out that way for me.
It might.
Do you want to talk to Jamie about it?
See, I don't know if that's such a good idea.
Amanda,
Vicky.
I love Jamie so much, and I don't know if he knows, but I really do, and I want our baby to love him too.
Have you told him that?
It's been a little difficult for us to talk, and that's why I was wondering if maybe you could talk to him for me.
I can't make any promises.
But you'll consider it.
All right. But give me a couple days.
Okay, guys, here you go. Mom will be here in a minute. Don't drink it all in one gulp.
I lay 10 to 1 that it wouldn't have gotten this far. 100 to 1.
Well, it's not over yet.
Of course not. Something's gonna come up that'll show that Mac is innocent.
Yeah, well, it better come up pretty soon. The waiting is making everybody crazy.
Rachel's running the company, huh?
She's trying to. It ain't easy. What is this, the antisocial hour?
You don't talk to the help anymore?
Jake!
Hey, guys.
Is there something I can get you?
Yeah, can I get a cup of coffee?
Coffee?
Coffee.
It's a bestseller. Coffee.
What an idea. Are you okay?
Yeah, things have been better, Ada.
Oh, that might be for me. I gave out this phone number so I couldn't try up the bar.
How are things going with the video?
Yeah.
All right.
Just all right? Okay. Hey, we'll try another subject. How's Marla?
She's okay.
Just okay. Not terrific, not super, just okay.
Things haven't changed. I mean, I thought they were going to get better, but they haven't.
The last time we talked, you said you had things pretty well worked out.
Well, that was before Marley's parents gave her conflicting advice.
Michael?
No, he's basically on my side.
Donna.
She'd do anything to split us up, man.
She can be talked to.
Right, by me, it's like banging my head in a brick wall.
You got a McKinnon head. It takes brick walls. You can't let somebody else decide what happens in your marriage.
Maybe you're right.
That's the spirit. Now you go out and give them as good as you get. No. Give them better.
Exactly right, Vince. It's exactly what I need. Thanks, buddy.
You know something, Ada?
What? I love you.
I love you, too. Who gave him a transfusion?
Oh, he just got the old McKinnon spirit back.
Oh, well, I wish you'd bottle it. We could use some of it over at the Corey house. I need you to type this up by the end of the day, if you have the time.
I'll make the time.
And I need 100 copies of this. It's the new staff contact sheet.
No problem.
Also, the top priority today is to get this over to Amanda's, if you wouldn't mind.
Well, oh, of course not.
It's the research material she asked for on for the article that she's doing on the First Ladies. Oh, and Mr. Bates, he wants you to take over some expense vouchers. She needs to sign them. Amanda does. I don't remember where I put them.
Well, I'll help you look.
Oh, wait a minute. I remember. I put them in here. They're not there.
Well, how about on top of the desk somewhere?
No, I didn't put them there. I put them in there. Maybe Liz took them by mistake. Actually, maybe Liz sent them over to Amanda.
Excuse me.
What are you doing here?
Me? Nothing.
Alone in Mr. Corey's office and you're doing nothing?
Well, yes. I mean, no.
Well, which do you mean?
Mrs. Corey was going over my work for this morning.
What was the work?
Making some copies and typing up a few things.
Why is she wasting her time doing things like that?
Well, it's my fault. I ran into her in the hall and I asked her what I was supposed to do today.
In the future, if you get confused, ask Liz Matthews. She shall instruct you as to what your duties are.
Hello, Evan. Jesse, we're going to have to forget about those vouchers. For the time being, Liz has no idea where they are.
What vouchers are you looking for, Mrs. Corey?
The vouchers you wanted Amanda's signature on.
Oh, I dropped those off to her before I came into work this morning.
Wait a minute, you took something out of my office without telling me?
Well, I knew that I would be in the neighborhood, so I just decided to free you up to do more important things.
Wait a minute, I can't believe it.
Just in view of that, may I make a suggestion? That Liz Matthews organize Josie's day from now on. You have more than enough to handle. Come on, let's make sure that Miss Matthews understands our new policy.
Seems to have a chip on his shoulder.
Oh, he's all right.
Well, something's not all right between the two of you. He wouldn't be doing all that yelling.
Well, he thinks he's right, and I think I'm right, and that's how arguments start.
And about what, Jamie?
Just let him work it out, Jason.
I'm trying to help him work it out, Charlotte.
You've been pumping him for the last half hour.
It's all right, Charlotte.
Whatever's bothering you is none of Jason's business, Jamie, or mine for that matter.
I'm trying to talk it out like a family. If he's got a problem, that's the way it's supposed to be.
You're the only one who's saying much.
So you open your big mouth. Jamie, I think you're very much like your old man. You really are.
Oh, yeah? How's that?
Well, you like one girl who's a very specific type, and you like another girl who's a very different type. Now, your dad had a lot of trouble deciding between your mom and Alice Matthews.
Don't go into that, Jason.
He might learn something about himself from what I'm saying, Charlie.
Jason, my father was always his own man. I knew that when I was a kid. I'd like to think that I am, too.
You are.
Yeah, you are, but your dad was always getting caught, trapped by women, but he could always spring his way free.
Jason, it's not a question of springing yourself free. This is a question of having to make a choice where no one gets hurt.
That is not the nature of choices, my friend, especially not where women are concerned.
Yeah, well, I'm beginning to find that out.
Women always seem to want to use you for their purpose.
Gee, Jason, men have been known to use women for theirs.
I'm just saying you ought to get a little something back for what you give.
Don't listen to him, Jamie.
A smart man never gets serious about a woman unless she's got enough bread to make it worthwhile.
Yeah, you can see how far that philosophy got him.
I just never had Jamie's luck, that's all. What luck? Vicky happens to be a very beautiful, very wealthy, very willing lady. And if I had that kind of luck, I would be sitting on Fuji Street.
Oh. I'm going back out to the garden. Do some more work. But things make sense.
What am I saying?
You really don't know, do you?
Don't you come down on my case.
Why are you bedeviling Jamie like that?
I wouldn't have to do that if he had been raised by his father's family, but instead he was raised by that black widow, Rachel.
Then he'd be as miserable as you are.
I am not miserable.
Now, you can fool some people, Jason, and you can fool yourself, but you can't fool me, and I don't think you're fooling Jamie either. So why don't you just let it go?
All I'm saying is that if I was lucky enough to have a beautiful, rich lady who I had gotten pregnant, who was in love with me, I think I would dump the other little mouse so that I could feather my nest while I had the chance.
Sure you would.
Yeah.
But luckily for all of us, you're not Jamie. So why don't you just go back to your blueprint so I can get my ironing done in peace? Oh! Well, look who's here.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to barge in like
that. No, that's quite all right. Jake, I would like to take a moment or two and try to dissuade you from any foolish ideas that Michael might have tried to put into your head.
Donna, please,
hey,
sweetheart, I didn't
foolish
say
ideas.
Well, maybe not to you, but
does Michael know that you're contradicting him behind his back, Donna?
He knows my opinion.
No, that's not what I asked you.
Jake, I'm under no obligation to tell you what Michael knows and what he doesn't know.
And, Donna, I'm under no obligation to take anything seriously that you have to say.
Jake, please, do not get
No, I am sick and tired of her bullying us. I'm not going to let her do it anymore, Marley.
How dare you accuse me of that?
I would accuse you of much worse, Donna, but Marley's here, and I won't say it out of respect.
You know, you have no idea what respect is.
Oh, and I suppose the high and mighty Jamie Frame does.
Why are you bringing him into this?
Well, don't you think you better get used to hearing his name? After all, he is going to make you a grandmother.
It's a lot more than you'll ever do.
Donna.
Sorry. So back to Jamie. Why did you bring him up?
I went to see Jamie today.
Who asked you to do that?
Some things, Donna, you don't need to be asked to do.
Fine. What did he tell you?
Nothing that's going to set your mind at ease, or mine for that matter.
He will do the right thing by Victoria.
I wouldn't bet on it, Donna.
Well, I will see to it that he does.
Yes, well, he might prove too much even for you.
Well, we'll just see if he is. Excuse me.
I'd like a special mailing to promote this, Rachel.
No. Mr. Bates has to approve any added expenses. Mitch's photography is very much more evocative. It's like poetry now.
Yeah, well, I guess both the Fowler brothers are artists in their own way.
Yes, I agree with you there. And Mr. Bates, that I've given the editorial approval for this mailing.
Is my word going to be enough for him?
If it isn't, tell him to come in and check with me. Oh, and Sam.
What, did I forget something?
Have you heard from Mitch since he went down to Atlantic City?
Yeah, he called last night.
Felicia broken the bank yet?
No, but he says she's trying real hard at it, so.
And Mitch?
Mitch is staying away from the tables. He's too busy photographing stuff in the casinos and on the boardwalk.
Hmm. That sounds like a good photographic essay. November issue could use some pizzazz.
Well, he was kind of hoping you'd be thinking along those lines.
Oh, excuse me, I interrupted.
Get out of here. No, we're just finished.
Sam, I've been trying to track you down. Seems your department had no idea where you'd gone.
Yeah, it's because I didn't tell them.
So I gathered.
What, you want me checking in and out of my office?
Well, it might be more efficient than wasting time tracking you down.
Well, now that you've tracked me down, what's on your mind?
Well, I thought we might discuss trimming your department budget.
I have nothing to do with that.
Yes, but there is a duplication of position that involves you.
In what way?
Well, Matt Corey created a new position in order to bring you back to this firm.
Yes, I know that.
Yes, and you and the art director share many of the same responsibilities and a large part of the budget.
What are you getting at, Evan?
A salary adjustment may be in order.
You want to lower my salary?
Oh, I thought we might discuss it.
Wait a minute, Evan. Mac hired Sam because he wanted to expand the art department.
I understand that, Mrs. Corey.
I don't think there's any further discussion necessary, then. Sam, you have to get those mechanicals down to the printer, don't you?
Right. Thank you, Rachel.
But it looks like I stepped on the wrong toes again.
Yes, you did. But it's all right. I bailed you out.
Okay.
Rachel, hello.
Donna.
Liz was away from her desk. I hope you don't mind my arriving unannounced.
I'm really busy, Donna.
Well, this won't take long.
Fine. Okay, come in. Sit down.
Actually, I think I would feel better just standing.
Fine. Whatever.
Rachel, we need to talk.
Fine.
I know this is difficult for both of us.
Well, then we might as well get on with it, hadn't we?
Right, right. Well, my daughters are the most important people in the world to me.
Admirable, not unnatural.
And their happiness and well-being means everything to me.
Yes.
And we, as parents, must protect their happiness, even if that means our children will resent us.
Donna, I'm afraid I don't know where this is going.
I'm talking about my daughter's pregnancy.
Marley's pregnant.
No, not Marley. Victoria.
Well, congratulations. I don't know what this has to do with me.
Rachel, you're going to have another grandchild in 6 months.
I beg your pardon?
Jamie is the baby's father.
That can't be.
Oh, he hasn't told you. Oh.
That's not possible.
Well, I'm afraid Victoria is proof that it is.
Jamie and Lisa are engaged.
Yes, but that won't be for long.
That is entirely up to Jamie.
Not if we don't allow it.
Donna, what are you suggesting?
I am suggesting that Jamie and Victoria be married as soon as possible.
Donna, I have absolutely no intention of interfering in my son's plans.
I see. Well, if you won't, then I will.
That would be most unwise.
Rachel, I was really hoping that you would cooperate with me on this.
It's unwise, too.
I didn't want to have to bring Mac or Michael into this, but you leave me no other choice.
Well, you're not going to get very far with Mac.
Oh, great. I see you speak for him as well as Jamie.
I'm speaking for myself, Donna.
Well, then what is your decision?
I just told you. It's up to Jamie to decide.
Well, that's not good enough.
It'll have to be good enough, Donna. I have no intention of interfering in this.
Fine. Then Michael and I will just take care of this ourselves. But you can rest assured that we will not allow our daughter to be taken advantage of by a spoiled and selfish young man whose profession should have taught him to be more careful.
Just the most well-behaved, precious.
precious little girl in the whole world, Miss Allie Fowler.
My, come on in.
She's beautiful. Oh, yes. Well, your mommy is working today, so I decided to take her off her hands for a couple of hours tonight.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hello. Well, what did you want?
Well, we came by to see Jamie.
Well, you just missed him. He just went into town. He drove in for some garden supplies.
Oh, that's too bad, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but he should be back if you want to wait around.
Oh, no, that's okay. Actually, I'll just get her back to her mommy. Okay, thank you, though, Charlie. Yeah.
Well, I thought that was your car, Vicky.
Hi, Jason.
Hi, Jason. This is Amanda Fowler's little girl. Isn't she a darling?
Yeah, if you like him young.
Sure. Oh, don't mind him. He likes to play this cynic.
Well, could you just tell Jamie that I stopped by?
Yeah.
You're not leaving already, are you? Give me a couple minutes. I want to talk to you about something.
All right. Make it quick.
Allie would probably love to see some of your Plymouth Rock layers, huh?
Of course.
In the barn.
Come here, you.
Oh, geez. Would you like to go see Charlene? There you go. Okay.
Yeah. Stay.
Very subtle.
It worked, Vicky. It worked.
All right. What do you want to talk to me about?
I thought maybe you could shed some light on why Jake came in here yelling at Jamie today.
I'm something.
Hi, Josie.
Grandma, we're gonna take this table right here, okay?
Fine. Just wave if you want a little pheasant on the glass, all right?
I'm sorry about my crazy schedule. I have these classes almost back to back.
Okay.
You know, I wanted us to have a nice, leisurely lunch.
That's out, I'm afraid. I've got to get back to Bravo in a few minutes.
Wait a minute. They give you a whole hour for lunch.
I know, but I don't want anyone to think I'm not interested in my job.
Who's gonna think that?
It's kind of difficult working there, Matt.
Well, sure. I mean, with Mac not being there to run the place.
It's just not as fun as I thought it was going to be.
Josie, it sounds like someone is giving you a hard time.
No. Not really.
Evan Bates.
Well, he's just trying to do his job. But he makes me so nervous.
I'll talk to my mom about him.
No, please don't. I mean, I don't want her to think I'm complaining after my first week.
No. I'll explain things to
her. Matthew, please. I don't want to spoil anything.
What could you spoil?
Well, your mom's kind of being nice to me, even though she wishes we weren't seeing each other.
Yeah, she kind of has eased up in that area.
So, don't rock the boat, okay?
Parlez du diable.
What?
We're getting out of here.
Why?
My mom is walking through the front door.
Hey! Hey! Still here.
Hi, Mom.
If you want to talk to Matthew, you just missed him.
Why would I want to talk to Matthew?
Oh, you do talk to Matthew once in a while, don't you?
Yes, when I can get his attention. I'm not here to talk to Matthew. I want your advice.
I'm flattered.
It's serious.
Serious? Right. Okay, shoot.
Donna came to my office to see me today.
That is serious.
And unpleasant.
What'd she want?
She claims that Vicky is pregnant.
She's right.
You knew about this?
Yes.
And you didn't tell me?
No.
Do you know that she thinks Jamie is the father?
Yes.
Why didn't you tell me this?
I thought you had enough to worry about.
You can't shut me out of things like this.
I thought Jamie would tell you.
Jamie was the one who told you?
Well, he had to have somebody to turn to.
He could have turned to me.
He thought you were under too much stress already.
This is not true.
Well, if Donna says that her daughter is pregnant, her daughter's pregnant.
No, I mean about Jamie being the father. Everybody knows Vicky. She's a very easy young lady.
Now, wait a minute.
It could be anybody, Mom. Just absolutely anybody.
Jamie told me he was the father.
That's because she told him. She'd do anything to get him. She would lie. She would cheat. I know.
Yes, you do.
Well, it didn't work, did it? It didn't work for me. It's not going to work for her. Only she's not going to use my son to learn about life. You've got to help me. We've got to stop this. Help me.
Jason, I don't know what you're talking about.
Just what I said. He came over here and he started yelling at Jamie.
Well, I didn't know anything about it.
Well, it's a dumb move. Jamie does not threaten.
Well, I didn't send Jake.
Well, if I were you, I would tell Jake to lay off. Otherwise, it's going to backfire on you.
Nothing is going to affect Jamie's decision now. He's a decent man, Jason. He's not going to drop me now.
Well, then that's what you got to rely on.
Right. He'll do the right thing.
That includes marrying you, huh?
Well, it looks like he has to now, doesn't he?
You're not going to get it by threatening him.
Jake won't be back.
Look, sometimes a gentle push is a lot more effective than a shove. And even you can't do that.
Well, then who will?
You're looking at him.
You?
Yeah, me.
Oh, yeah, you would do that for me.
Sure.
Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. What's in it for you, Jason?
Nothing. Uh-huh. Not now. I got nothing specific in mind, but maybe sometime in the future, if I get in the jam, maybe you can bail me out.
I see.
Then we understand each other, right?
Protection.
Now that is a beautiful sight. Guess I'm probably not the first one to say that.
Sounded original to me.
Yeah, mother and daughter. Hello, mother. Hi, daughter.
So how'd it go at work? Huh? Sam?
Why'd you move my canvases around?
Well, I was looking at them.
Really? Why?
I like to look at them when you're not here. They're good, Sam. They're really good.
Yeah, and you're prejudiced, too.
I just hate to see you wasting your talent.
Wait a second. I thought you just said I was good.
What I mean is you're doing graphics instead of painting.
Yeah, well, I got no complaints about that. At least not about that.
Oh, what is it that you have to complain about?
Oh, one thing. One guy, Evan Bates.
He got to you, huh?
Well, let's not talk about it, okay?
No, what did he do?
He's butting into things that are none of his concern.
Like what?
Like, let's talk about it after lunch. Okay?
You know, he stopped by here today.
Evan Bates was over here?
Yeah, he dropped off some expense vouchers that I had to sign.
Look, Amanda, I don't like that guy hanging around while I'm at work.
Well, okay? He wasn't here long.
Well, from now on, if something needs to come to you from work, I'll bring it, all right?
Okay, yeah, I guess that sounds best.
Yeah, and I'll make sure he knows that, too.
No, look, don't start anything at the office, please. Mom and Dad have enough to worry about besides trying to referee office politics.
All right. We'll forget about that. We'll forget about Evan Bates and anything that has to do with anything else but us. Right, Ellie?
Yeah.
So how was your date?
Ooh, that's a big smile, isn't it?
Yeah. Ooh.
Michael, everything is just fine. No, we will talk about that when you get home. All right, I love you, too. No, I'm handling that. You don't have to worry about a thing. Okay, bye-bye.
What are you handling now?
Victoria!
What are you handling?
I have been looking for you. Where have you been?
I've been taking care of Allie for Amanda. Are you going to answer my question now?
Oh, well, she's so lucky to have such a good friend.
Well, she does a lot of favors for me, too.
Good. I just hope she's more reliable than her brother.
What is that supposed to mean?
It means I hope she stands by you through this ordeal.
Ordeal? Like, if you're gonna talk about my pregnancy, I would really appreciate it if you would use a less depressing word than ordeal.
Well, that's exactly what it's going to be if certain people don't cooperate.
Certain people? Like who?
Rachel Corey, for one.
Well, I don't want her involved in this.
Well, she already is.
How do you know?
Because I talked to her this afternoon.
Oh, no.
Do you know she was really rather rude and very arrogant?
And you were charming and gracious, I'm sure. I take it you told her about my baby.
Yes, I did. And she was rather shocked to hear the news, especially
that Jamie's the father.
Well, I wish you hadn't done that.
I was just taking care of your interests.
Well, you could have asked me first.
Well, honey, there are certain things that a mother has to handle.
You know, Jamie is gonna think I planned this whole thing.
Well, who cares what he thinks, as long as he does the right thing by you?
Please let me handle this by myself.
Well, you're not doing anything.
Yes, I am.
What? What are you doing?
I have Jason Frame on my side.
You what?
Jamie and Jason are extremely close.
I don't care. I don't want you to have anything to do with that man. Do you understand me?
Well, I don't want you to have anything to do with me and my baby. I'm gonna fight my own battles, okay? You always make things worse.
Yeah, we just finished. Well, I don't know. It was some wonderful concoction that Charlene cooked up. Yeah, it was really good. I'll have to see if I can steal you the recipe. Oh, I don't know. I think I'll just grab a cup of coffee and do some reading. Yeah, I miss you too. I love you too. I didn't hear you drive up.
Oh, I parked down the road in Walkley.
Why would you do that?
Needed time to think.
Yeah, things must be getting pretty rough down at the office, huh?
Oh, actually, I was thinking about you and Vicky.
Vicky.
Why didn't you tell me? Mom knew. All sorts of other people knew. Why didn't you come to me?
Mom, I...
It's all right. I love you anyway.
I love you too.
Why don't you come home? You belong home with your family.
Catch your favorite Classic Days episodes weeknights at 7, part of the Days Decathlon, only on SoapNet.